recently finished this fan fiction. I just reread it. It hasn't been updated recently. It's a good one. And never been so vocal. A lot of times I don't comment in fan fictions, even though I want to. Because I don't like, get backlash or anything. What happens when you're overthinking the entire night is just like me just making a whole bunch of comments. And I read the same fanfiction like early last year. I just don't want to move, man. I hate that it recharges. This is actually good pasta. It actually just sucks. Then it just gets stuck in your teeth. I've also learned I don't really like peas. It's kind of funny. I grew up eating them, and now I don't like them. God dang it. God. Yeah, you have. In order to win, the player must survive and reach 1,000 points. I'm just spending my entire time doing this. Thank you. happened? I beat it? Did I beat it? Yeah, suck it, Pink Flies. I thought this was gonna take me so much. I'm gonna cry. I'm gonna cry. I can't cry much, but I wanna cry. So happy. Supposed to go talk. Dang, my pasta got cold fast. I am so happy. Oh my god. Oh no, I already did this. I didn't know I had to move. A note wishing you the best, Henry. Oh, Sal! Gotta get a brother, bro. Are you ready? Oh, see? You had to go do everything else before reaching the temple, I believe. But so far, I just need to read more pages, speak with the ghost of a cultist in order to finish. Which, the cultist. Security cameras and we'll be able to loop the call and tell you to get back. Be careful. Where does she live? Cool. Oh, bro, she's your neighbor. That's good. Got it. Nice, we should go quick before she gets back. Old feet. Lord, we better make this a short visit. I can't take that sector too long. Check out that painting. What if they'll just work on a farm? I don't know. That painting gives me a weird feeling, like a cold chill. Oh, yeah, I feel it too. Honestly, that painting just looks awful. Let's look around. Thank you.
idiot.
So I keep thinking my bite departs at 9. Big thing of diapers. Do you think Mrs. Paxton can use them for herself? Paxton is ancient. What's the last time she cleaned that? Gross, there's a big old log in there. Someone got an F. What if I just fridge? No, looks like a normal, looks like normal groceries and stuff. But there's a padlock on the freezer. Can you get it open? Yeah, just give me a minute. Have windows. Got it. All right, let's open it up. That. Look at that. The I don't know. Satan symbol. Yo, is surrounded by Satan symbols. It is goats. I fuck all that shit. Well, if you think about it, goats aren't that big. Donald thinks so. Also gross. I feel like it can't be that simple. Let's get to the bedrooms. Alright. Hi, little buddy. Oh, that's a little disturbing. One, two. What the hell was that? A ghost goat, apparently. That probably shouldn't be surprising me at this point, but I definitely did not see that coming.
My lips are dry.
Been learning a lot of skincare, trying to be a bit of self-care, trying to be happier, really happier. I love lip therapy though, Vaseline lip therapy. This is a cute tiny container. And you know, of course, it's a specific kind of lip therapy, rosy lips, because I remember seeing a little clip is putting that on Jungkook's lips. Except with the makeup, not the time for that. I'm gonna make a push. I'm trying to attach it. It's locked, and there's some weird mechanism on the door. They're stuck at the beginning. I try to move them, they just might. They just go. 14. Bizarre lock, dude. I'm not sure if I can pick it, but I'll keep trying. 314. One, bah. Two, one, two. I don't like how this is acting. One, two, one, two. One oh four seven. Okay, which one? I think it has 1212. Huh. I don't like the first better. Let's check it out. Alright, that's what that goat was for. Thank you so much, goat. I don't know whose numbers these are except for one person. Bedroom one. Mr. Hello? How do you know if it's Mr. Packerton or not? I don't think he hears you. You're right. Looks like he's in some kind of vegetative state. This is fucked. And definitely where that rancid smell is coming from, too. Yuck. Let's get a quick look around and then get out of here. All these papers are talking about the death of Mr. Packerton. If he's dead, then who's laying in that bed? Mm-hmm. I want to know, there's so many shit-filled diapers in here. Like, seriously. Like, what the fuck? I know what you mean. This apartment's making me super nauseous. You don't think it uses the... No, no, never mind. I don't even want to think about it. If the mystery ingredient was human shit, Ta would have seen some signs of that left, right? I guess so. Well, honestly, I have no idea. Let's just hurry up in here. Are you Mr. Packerton? Blink if you can hear me. Hello? Because he's in a vegetative state. Young child, please help me. How can you get me dead? I am in between, suffering for what seems like eternity. Did Mrs. Kraken do this? We were in love once. So I think, yes, this is her doing. Please, you must help me escape the endless agony. What's in the baloney? Baloney? I'm afraid I don't know much about that. This ruined my brain. I came with it, so I can't believe in this. How can I help you? You must unplug this weird machine. Wouldn't that? It will end my suffering. It will free me. But... are you sure? Please, I beg of you, you must hurry before she returns. What if I say no? No. You don't understand what it's like being trapped between life and death. My soul's being torn apart. Oh, okay, so you just do it anyway. Unplugged it? Oh, he's all the way over there, though. I don't... Sorry, dude. The poor guy was in pain. You heard him. That's what he wanted. Like that. Honestly, yeah. I just want to see what would happen. Guess so. Oh, shit! She's back! Quick! Dresser! If we don't make it out alive... I think this is the shiniest I've ever seen. Sal. Dude, I love you too, man. You're the best friend I've ever had, you know? Same to you, little bud. Get out there! Hey, sorry, but what the hell is this place? Ash, you scared the crap out of us! I can see that. To see you, Ash. I thought we were done for. I thought you had to watch Benjamin. My dad, so I rode over here straight away. Sorry for giving you guys a scare eye. Is that Mr. Packerton? Is he? It was him. He's gone now. He's finally at peace. Damn. And please don't tell me this is what's going on. I hope not. I'm not sure. There's still one room we haven't looked in yet before we leave. Oh, check this out. While we were hiding, I found the key ring under the dresser. One of these keys has to open that other bedroom. Let's check it out. Anything to get out of the room. If Ash hadn't shown up, we found those weird keys. Glad to be of service. You guys must save him right. We're in. What in the... Oh my god! You know, she has more posters of the missing kids on the wall. This can't be good. Fuck. It's like some kind of slaughter factory in here. It's definitely a slaughter factory. Look, there's shoes and clothes and those garbage bags. Question is, how do I find the freezer number? That's another question. And eyeballs. We're in way over our heads here. We need to get help. There are no bones. What? There aren't any bones in here. Meat. The truth is, it's just all skin, intestines, eyeballs, brains. Dude, no. Oh, poor Larry. Actually, we should get help. Don't you see? There's no one who can help us. Every time something happens here, it's covered up. The cult, Charlie, Mrs. Sanderson, who knows what else this place has hidden. Okay, hold on. Does Larry, Luke? We can't trust the cops, and we can't tell our parents because they'll want to go to the police. They haven't believed anything we've told them about. Then what do we do? I don't know, man. Just keep getting worse. Pakistan's chopping people up and starving them to. Ugh. I don't think I'll ever look at Belinda the same again. Definitely don't, because you can't stand it. Well, what? Stories you spin, you're really not going to tell us what happened next? Well, you say a fantastical story. Even if he finishes telling the story, you're not gonna believe him anyway. So what's the point of finishing the story for your stupid ass? Exactly. Why bother? You probably don't believe what I've said up until now anyways, and the story just gets more unbelievable from this point. Plus, you're probably gonna cut it up to make me sound like a lunatic on TV. I don't trust you. Even if you say give us the rest of the story and we'll air it in its entirety without cuts, I promise. See, you can promise, but here's the thing. You work for someone. You work for the company, whoever you're doing this for, to get this story. So it's not your call. I heard you mention Todd Morris's name before we started. Did you visit him? They won't tell me anything here. We shot a segment on him yesterday. Is he okay? Is he still in the hospital? I'll tell you what. You finish the balloon story, and I'll tell you about Todd. Before we left Mrs. Packerton's room, Ash noticed something else. This is actually pretty detailed, too. Hey, guys, come look at this. Behind that painting. That's weird. This building doesn't have trash chutes. Look like it goes outside. There's no light moving. I don't like that. Be careful. I wonder where it leads. Ash! Are you okay? Ash! Oh no, this can't be happening. Please let her be. We have to find where this leads to. How are we, what are we? I'm gonna shoot down. It's the only way. Dude, I'm not thinking straight. What if you fall too? Or land on her? If she's still. Killer. Okay. Oh, here it is. Oh, okay. So this is the rest of the words. You know what? I'm gonna write it along with the blanks that I wrote down. So let's see. E, Q, N, E, A, O, S, E, S, E, T, E, T, K, E, T, K, L, O, E, A, O. L, S, L, O, S, H, M, R, so H, M, R, T, R, H, M, F, E, R, O, D, I, N, T, U, U, Y. Right, so this message is backwards. Which means you must unbind your this world. So you are not L-I-K-E T-H-E O-T-H-E-R-S period E-Y-U-O-A-R-E So the message being said is you must unbind yourself from this world, Sal. You are not like the others. You are unique. I know where it goes. What? Oh, never mind. Just go get caught and meet me in the basement. What's going on? Is Ashley alright? Everything's going to be okay. Come with me with this. This apartment in a long time. It's in rough shape as the renovations it needs, just like the just when you saw the vision sign. It doesn't work like that. It's more like intuition. Alright, lead the way. There and out. Offer support. Talk. Wait, one of those keys will have things like the old apartment keys. Try that out. Oh yeah, I almost forgot about those. Why else would the race turn up here? It looks like. Guys, come check us out. That's the basement level. It's definitely not any of the blueprints that I've seen. It's an old barrack cellar or something of the like. I had no idea this was here. Tell you how wrong. The third key from Mrs. Packerton's fits in the store. Ash must be down there. It's the only shoe could lead to. Dirt cellar. The heavens arrange me infinite, everlasting. Well, this. Yep. Incredible. This architecture must date back to centuries at least. Centuries of blood and demon worship. This is freaky as hell. Aren't the layer of dust, which likely means the area, is presently vacant and has been for a while. Let's hope that the malevolent history of this place remains in the past. Yeah, well, we need to get through that gate somehow. There appears to be. Absence. Any obvious is a large gate. It must be built into the walls. It's likely that the upper opening gate is hidden. I better split up and search the room. Alright. So. I'm supposed to walk towards the bottom. Go. Off screen. It's empty. Oh wait, there's another at the bottom with my name on it. What page is this? Page 9. Alright. I don't want anything to cut out. I'm gonna read the page down in there. So. Tragedy prevails once again. The loss of Abe is still more. He's devastated. He hasn't left the bedroom in a few days. I tried my best to explain to Larry, but he's so young that he doesn't fully understand. He's angry at us because he's excited about getting my baby sister. Damn. Our happy family has this giant crack in it now. Well, that's what it feels like, at least. So obviously it's making this even harder to bear. I hate seeing her in pain like this. It breaks my heart. I'm sitting in the groceries. It's freezing. But I let the cold take me. Addison Apartments, the small five-story, protruding from the dark forest, looming over me. I want to scream. Why? Why do I deserve it? But I am not so self-centered to think that the universe owes me anything, the thing for me to do now is be there for my family as we attempt to crawl out from this hole. So, this will just cause a lot of devastation. Alright, well, we got that. And so, we gotta go through Larry's point of view. Strange that a place like this has lights. It must have been installed later on. Though this green bulb in particular is I've never seen a bulb quite like it. How do you turn it on? It's another mystery. There are no visible lights switches all around this area. Huh. Lovely. The text is written in another language and the pages smell like rotten flesh. This book gives me a bug, at least a strong sensation. System. Once activated, energy is transferred to the floor below. Additionally, you must be harnessing the same type of energy as Super Gear Boy admits, since you're able to get him with them. To be honest, I'm not totally sure. This technology isn't like anything I've dealt with before. However, that these things were used for something supernatural. Perhaps even as some of the red-eyed demon. It's a good thing the cult isn't around anymore. The demon too. Oh, how wrong you are, poor child. After we find Ash, we should smash everything just in case. Actually, I'd like to study some of these things. It may prove useful. What's with all the spikes? Like, dude, you can't turn around without stubbing your thumb. Shit hurts like hell, too. Symbol on the cover of a bird within a circle. This is an only language, so I can't read it. Blood is spider on some of the pages, but the book is a bird across the page. Touching this makes me feel lightheaded, as if it's producing a strange energy. Okay, so. Just got bigger. Scope it out. What? I want to see if Todd has anything to say about this. Man, you're making him do the work. The gate open for a second, but the switch will stay down. Todd, can you come down so Larry and I can go find Ash while you make sure we don't get locked in? Sure, I can do that. How we get kidnapped? Shit. Ready? No, but Ash is so let's go. Be safe, you two. I don't want to lose anyone else down here. Split up. I was afraid you were gonna say that. Alright, so Larry. Things always. Alright, so. Edge over right. So I went that way. I need to go the other way. crap. This place is a maze. What that did. Turn the previous hall and the door. Figure out how to open this stupid gate. So, you're supposed to hit the middle door first. The middle door goes through the middle. You're supposed to take the left. And then the door on the right. Move in the next room. Go back to the hall and the door at the end of the room. To ignore the panel puzzle. But should I walk across it? So, if I ignore it, I'm supposed to light necrolights for the cult ghost. I'm slightly worried, and I I've made it quite far. Okay, so I am right. I just really, really don't want to mess up. Okay, so that must be a cultist from chapter 6. Foretold of the one who hath the power to ignite the without the performing of rituals. It break off the part of your bold mint thingamajig or whatever. This is just a video system.
I love that.
Friend Todd modified it to produce a Cersei. I don't have any magic powers or anything. Twas thee who was did die, and without the sacred text, 'tis you who I hath waited. This I am certain of. My time here is brief, so I must fulfill my obligation for thee. Take may the gods bless thee with the safe journey and the courage and strength for what I said. But Liza. Every time. Alright, so one more, which is getting all pages of the journal. Gladly read it right now. Page 10. Last night I had the most horrible nightmare. There was a man in the shadows standing on a path. He was trying to tell me something, but I couldn't make out any of his words. I looked down at my eyes. I was standing in a pool of blood. The entire ground was blood. I mean, beyond that was simply dark. A bony, cold hand grasped my shoulder. As I turned around, a familiar face came to focus. It was Rosenberg. Though she looked skewed, and her eyes were something that had risen from the dead. When she opened her mouth, maggots poured out. Her tongue smacked against her gums and lips as she spoke. Her words again continued to haunt me even after waking. If you do not join us, everything you love will wither and die. Okay, so it's nightmares. If you do not join us, so that's why he did what he did. Spoke, I saw Sari and Lisa's twisted corpses. Today I decided to finally meet with Rose. She revealed to me an old temple that rests in this very building. A small group of people meet here to carry on the traditions of an ancient society. They believe in an arcane magic that seems dark and unnatural. I wouldn't have believed any of this if not for the fact that I've witnessed its power firsthand. Yet, magic, I believe it to be something else. A thought frightens me, but I must uncover the truth. The journey I'm embarked on may be the last thing I do, but I must do everything I can to protect my unseen darkness. Damn. last room. Ash has to be back there. Alright, so this is the last room. So, we walk right. An old book with a metal cover. This one has complicated geometric pattern on the cover with bizarre scripture. Standing near this book, I can feel a slight ringing noise. It almost seems as though the book itself is emitting a low frequency. It's a little disorienting. Hold on, hold on. This one has a symbol that almost looks like an hourglass. The pages are stiff. Look at this, Macy. Looking at this is making me tear up. I can't help feeling a deep, unexplainable sadness. Huh. Alright, now since this is the last room, we walk all the way to the right, off screen. Hold on. I need to know if the center is now. So I just need this page. Oh, Jesus. It's taking me so long. Okay. Huh? I think this weird hex thing from Mrs. Packerton's desk is some kind of key. There's a podium. It's the last journal page. I did it. Alright, let's go. Alright, okay. Page 11. Oh. This is after he's gone, after he's disappeared. Please read this journal I've kept over the past years, so that you will begin to understand what is at stake. I know Lisa and Larry must hate me for leaving, but please know that I have loved them, and love them still, beyond anything else in life. And that is the very reason I had to protect them. Man, that's always sad, when you always have to leave to protect your family. And I'm glad that you and Larry will form a strong kinship. This must seem very, and I haven't got much time to explain it. In short, there are forces at work here that are far beyond imagination. I've seen glimpses of the future. I've seen glimpses of the past. Now I must play the role I was. I will sacrifice my life for those I love. Put an end to this madness, to put the dreadful darkness in this world. You must never reveal the truth, Lisa. Well, that's sad. I would gladly tell Larry, if anything. Because he's so sad that his dad left them. Honestly, Sal had the world on his shoulder. This is like, a kid who carries on their shoulders. So normally in animes, it's a kid 16 years old. Oh, maybe he's 16. I don't know. His height just makes me think different. That's how the fact that you're short. They will only go digging for answers and in danger. Please, Sal, you must protect them from me. For your family, that makes you my family too. I'm sorry your life has been filled with tragedy, and I'm sorry to say that there is more misfortune. But you are destined to play an important role in all this. In time, brother. Sincerely, Jim Johnson. This makes me so sad. If he can see the future, then he knows that his wife had moved on. It was for the best. Ash! Ash, okay? Ash? Is she... She's still breathing. Come on, help me get her up. Broken bones. Well, none of mine at least. Man, Ash, you wouldn't believe what we went through to find you. It's all thanks to Sal. He had one of his vision thingies in. Old cellar door in the basement. And then we went down these long creepy stairs. And we found this crazy ass cult or some shit down here. And there were all these puzzles and traps missing. And Todd is holding for us. We should go back there. Wow, this is so much to take in. Right below the apartments. Thanks for coming for me. I don't know what I'd do without you guys. So what are we gonna do about all of this? Paxton has killed a lot of people. And the baloney. Ugh. Just ignore this. Definitely not. Judging by what you guys told me about the inner rooms of the temple and about the apartment. Be possible that she's gotten herself wrapped up in the occult as well. Even if the investigation has long since dissolved, could have stumbled upon or maybe she's the last remaining member trying to carry out whatever the plan. You don't think she's trying to bring the red-eyed demon back to you? But we'll be prepared if she does. Man, or preferably before that happens. I know. Going to local police isn't often. Maybe we should call the state police or the FBI or something. This time, our parents can't deny what's happening. They'll help us once we show them what's below the building and what has been doing. Ash is right. We should get our parents involved this time. Freaking, like, maybe we should just kill her. What? Jesus. Larry. Mrs. Packerton, maybe we should kill her. She's old, so it shouldn't be hard. What the heck, Larry? We can't just kill someone, Larry. Better than her. Oh, God! Normally I would be a guest harming others, but in this case, Larry might be right. Larry! Seriously, you guys? Think about all the strange, unexplainable occurrences that happen in Addison Apartments and in Knoxville in general. The more I think about it, the less likely it becomes that Mrs. Packerton is acting alone. She must be outside help. I'm happy that you state this because it's true. It would explain the police cover-ups of Charlie and the Holmes family murders. How far this reach it. God damn. I guess that makes sense. Sal, you were selling here today too. I don't know. Maybe this does fall on us to take care of. Maybe. also to the fact that all dreams and vision things that he has to keep them a secret. He has to keep Jim's journal a secret. And it's can't confide in anyone about it. The biggest worries normal teenagers have are about petty things like being popular and having nice hair. Not us, though. We just have to worry about saving the world, I guess. We decided to sleep on it. It was the morning anyway, and everyone was beyond exhausted. And the teacher, what did you do to the police? Didn't have to. Turns out Paxton got into a car accident on the way home that same night. She and the other driver were hacked. That other driver purposely did it. It's we've been exposed, and it's because of you. You must be eliminated. And it's like, it's like kamikaze pilots. Wow, quite convenient. You can look it up for yourself if you don't believe it. It was on the front page the next day. Beloved Knoxville High's teacher, by drunk driver. Of course you won't find anything about the dead body in the apartment or how he was feeding the students human flesh. That was all covered up. I see. I don't care if you don't believe me. It's the truth, and you said you would air the full story. Don't worry, Sal. It will be aired in full. I've always heard, and I think the people will be very interested in what you have to say. Everyone is listening to you now. You spoke this about your friend Ash. I understand that you were very close. You considered her one of your best friends, Ray Johnson and Tom Morrison. Is that true? Have you seen this? Sources say the prosecutor will call Ashley Cameron to testify against the Sally Face killer. Oh, wait, there's an arrow. About Todd. You said you'd tell me about Todd. Oh, right, of course. We shot a segment on Morrison yesterday. He's still in the hospital after what happened that night. He's still out of it, unresponsive. So we couldn't have a conversation with him. He spoke with his doctor. I'm sorry, Sal. Apparently Morrison hasn't shown any signs of improvement. In fact, his condition has been getting worse. Say that the damage he suffered that night is irreversible. He doesn't know from reality, and all he wants is to die. This does not look like Todd. He's possessed. When he's denied the release of death, he becomes extremely violent. I need to help him. Somehow, I need to help him. I hate when people say that. Even though doctors and trained professionals haven't been able to help Todd, I suppose I'd be able to. I don't. It's always like, it's like, oh, we're professionals. We know what we're doing. It's just like, okay, you know what you're doing, but you do not have an emotional connection with these people. That's how some people are. They, even if it's a professional, yeah, they could help majority of the time. But sometimes, there needs to be an emotional connection. That's just my opinion. And the fact I've seen, that's what happens in, like, shows and stuff. Like, who wakes up? Who do you wake up to? Someone you have an emotional connection with. Because I know the truth. I know what really happened. I know what's wrong with Tom. Hell no. His eyes are gonna glow red. Finally, I've completed episode 3. Oh, I literally said that episode came out, but I actually beat it. And not as long as I thought it would. So, I guess it's not just clumpy now. But this is episode 3. Thank you for watching. Later.